So welcome to the world of the singing show. Let me make you sing and you taste buds. When all we want for you to see is how we're living in a blessed country. Hello guys, welcome to the Singing Chef Show. I'm your host, Eon John, and I'm going to take you through a Christmas menu that we have, and we're going to do just a few episodes that are going to give you a little bit of an idea of what you can maybe add a little bit different to your Christmas table, and thanks to TBN. Lovely. Okay. Thank you for joining us again. Right, now today we're gonna do Guyanese sunshine rice. Yes, yes, yes. I'm telling you, all these ingredients here is almost like the smell again. It's like it's saying, put me in the pot, put me in the pot. Okay, all right, here we go. We have chicken, right? And it's still on the bone, but I chop it up fine, fine, fine. Right, and then that's just turmeric and a little bit of cayenne pepper on the top. Same with our shrimp. I spent all night last night actually de-shelling this. And what I did was I took the shells and I made a stock out of it, right? You shouldn't throw away those shells because I'm telling you, those shells make such a delicious stock, right? And this is chicken and shrimp stock here, right? And all those two are the main ingredients. These three are like the triangle that's gonna cook our sunshine rice. That's 2 cups of rice. Here on the side here, we've got Chinese barbecue sausage, tomatoes, pumpkin, not carrots, okay? Pumpkin. I pureed some onion there, but don't worry about that. That's about 3 onions, right? You can chop it up. It doesn't really matter. I'm just perfectionist. Anyway, so and then we got some pepper right here. This is Guyanese sweet pepper, Guyanese corn. I took off the actual stalk myself. And then we have some weary, weary pepper. I'm gonna show I wanna bring this out. Because it's not Guyanese if it's not weary, weary pepper in there. And then it's we got some garlic. And then we have some scallions. Now, all this, these three, you do to taste. All of these, the tomatoes, the onions, all this kind of stuff, you do to taste as well. You know, because this Guyanese sunshine rice, it's like when you're cooking a cook-up, it's just an alternative to cook-up rice, right? You put what you need to put in there that's gonna make you feel like you're doing something special. Okay, right, now here, tomato paste. I got lime juice and lemon juice, right? So hold on, we're not finished yet. It's paprika, smoked paprika. You can use normal paprika, okay? And here we got like a little bit of allspice, Chinese allspice, turmeric, black pepper, and some salt. Now all the measurements are gonna be available to you on screen, so I don't really need to go back over that because there's so many ingredients, I think, and it's screaming to get into that pot. So I think we gotta start cooking. What do you think? Yeah, let's start cooking. First, we gotta start this fire. Oops. Let's get this thing going. Okay, here we go. Wish me luck. Jesus. This thing could be. Oh, there we go. My gosh, why do you do this at me every time? I tell you what, this is like, you know, this is like a sibling. Anyway, so let's put some oil in there. This is all one pot. It's brilliant. It's brilliant. I'm telling you. This is so cool. You don't have to worry about anything. Once it gets in the pot, you're doing the right way, which there's no really right way. Just get it in the pot. But the first thing is what you want to do is soften up your onions and the vegetables, right? Now the onions are already pureed, so I don't really have to worry that much about this. So I'm just gonna stick those in, right? But don't wait for the pot to get hot. Big, big, big thing is don't wait for the pot to get hot. What you do is you just get it in the pot, right? Soon as you put in the oil. It's very important. Right, so let's stir that around with the onions. I'll put the pumpkin in because the pumpkin is actually the thing that's gonna take the longest to cook. Right. Put your peppers in. Oh, yes. Boy, this thing, if you know the smell that's coming off of this thing, it's ridiculous. Okay, put the corn in. Right. There's so many ingredients in this thing. You wonder if it's gonna fit in the pot. I'm sure it will. Okay, so let's put in, I want it all aromatic. So I'm gonna put the wiriwiri pepper, the garlic, and the scallions. I'm gonna leave some of the scallions in there just to garnish it in the end, right? Let's put that there, right? And let's just keep this baby cooking. And just turn it up a little bit, right? Now, so we're gonna put in the tomato, and I could do this up. That's the lime and lemon juice and the tomatoes, right? So we're getting this cooking nice. And we're kind of making almost like a paste with all this, right? And you wonder when we're gonna add the rice. Wait, hold on, the rice is actually the last thing they had in, they add in here, okay? Okay, we put in the Chinese sausage because it's gonna flavor it. Turn this up a little bit more. Right. And we're gonna put in our paprika, Chinese allspice, turmeric, black pepper, and a tablespoon of salt. Oh, lovely. Okay. All right, and now what we wanted this to do is we wanted to flavor the meat first. And then, once this is flavored, then we put the rice in and the stock. Okay. So, we're gonna put the meat in, which is our chicken, we're gonna put in there. Lovely. Make sure it all gets covered. And the reason why I'm using tiny shrimp is because the tiny shrimp has actually more flavor than the big shrimp. Big shrimp, it looks impressive, but you don't, the type of flavor you get now, this tiny shrimp is quite incredible. Okay, so that's about 3 cups of tiny shrimp, which that will take you all night to do, but get your family to help you. This could be like a family job. Remember the old days when we used to pick rice? A lot of guys don't know. Oh my gosh. Yes, the old days where we used to pick rice. You used to come in the kitchen, you know, your mother cooking, and he said, "Mommy, that smells good." She said, "All right, yes, but you need to help me. You just sit down and pick some rice." That's when you want to cry, right? And oh gosh. Oh my gosh. Anyway, that used to take a while, but you know, family is family, right? And when your mom tells you to do something, you better do it. Okay, I almost forgot my tomatoes. Look, they're hiding right there. This tomato. Tomatoes don't add sweet. They actually add like a tanginess. That's why they use it in so many different types of Moroccan cooking, Spanish cooking. It's because, you know, they add a lot of tanginess, right? And so, we're going to add the rice now. The last of ingredients. Lovely. Okay, right, we're going. Okay, let's just mix this all together. Look, the rice is gonna disappear, but don't worry, when this thing pop up, oh my gosh. I'm hoping it's gonna stay in the pot. Oh gosh. All right, here we go. Mix it all together because you really wanna get it before you add your stock. And I'm not cooking in water, you're cooking in stock. You can use vegetable stock, you can use chicken stock. You can use beef stock, whatever kind of stock that you've got, right? But if you can, when you actually eating meat or vegetables and all that kind of stuff, try to make your own stock at home. All you have to do is just put in the pot with some bay leaves or even like a bit of carrot or whatever and just let it cook and don't salt it. Leave it so that it just, and then that salt, you can salt your food later on. And you won't believe you get like really good flavors. But also you can use the stuff that's ready made as well. It doesn't really matter, right? Because not a lot of people have so much time. Not like I have a lot of time, but I just love it. Okay, right. So that's 2 cups of rice to 4 cups. This is how you're gonna just get what you're supposed to do with this, right? To 4 cups of whatever stock you're using, right? So I'm pouring in the stock, and there. Okay, now that is gonna take, I reckon, I think it's going to burst out to the park. I'm sure it's going to burst out. But that's good. It's more food for everybody. That's going to take about 20 to 25 minutes to completely cook. And that's longer than normal rice because, remember, it's got to cook everything and it's got to cook everything together. So we'll let that cook for about 25 minutes. And then we'll come back and then we're going to have something really lovely to eat. Guyanese sunshine rice. Yes.
Yeah. Welcome to the world of the singing chef. We gonna make you sing and you taste good breath. From the Pomeroon River to the East Coast, my beast to the East Bank Shore to Georgetown City. I can win you up a boat to the hinterlands, from the Quarantine River to Linden Town. All we want for you to do is sit back and enjoy the show. Just take your time and then come, let me eat a fine wine. Welcome to the world of the singing chef. Let me make you sing and it tastes buzz well. Coconut water. So welcome to the world of the singing chef. Let me make you sing and it tastes buzz well. All we want for you to see is how we're living in a blessed country.
And look, oh, look how lovely that's bubbling. I almost forgot something. God. You know, sometimes you just forget things. Okay, this is big leaf thyme, which is actually sage, it's not thyme. Anything you see a furry leaf like this, but Guyanese, we call it what we call it, and we know it as big leaf thyme. And this is Suriname thyme, which gives a really lovely, deep earthy flavor to it. So right, I'm gonna be putting it in there because it needs it, because it's so sunshiny. I don't want it to sort of just walk off the plate. I need some earthing. Okay, so here we go. All right, so I'm gonna chop this up with my faithful friend. Yeah, I think that's fine enough. And there we go. Into the pot. Yes! Right, just got a wait a little bit longer, and we're there.
Yeah. Welcome to the world of the singing chef. We gonna make you sing and you taste good breath. From the Pomeroon River to the East Coast, my beast to the East Bank Shore to Georgetown City. I can win you up a boat to the hinterlands, from the Quarantine River to Linden Town. All we want for you to do is sit back and enjoy the show. So just take your time and then come, let me eat a fine wine. Welcome to the world of the singing chef. Let me make you sing and you taste buzz well. So welcome to the world of the singing chef. Let me make you sing and you taste buzz well. All we want for you to see is how we're living in a blessed country. Yeah.
Not today. I'm going to do a song called Guess What? Because we're doing Guyanese sunshine rice, which is like a form of like a paella, but it's got all sorts of Guyanese ingredients of it. We're using Guyanese rice, we're using Guyanese loveliness, and also we're using like pumpkin that's in there. Oh my God, it's so sexy. Anyway, I'm gonna do a song, a beautiful song, because it's sunshine rice. I've written a song that is sunshine, about sunshine. Okay, here we go.
Close your eyes and go to bed. Tomorrow we can sing another song. Butterflies and fingernails and all those funny, funny tales. Funny how a little dose can be so strong. I beg your pardon, I never promised you a herb garden. I watch the sunshine turn rain. Little robin, sing to me. Teach me all your melody. The memories still keep coming on.
rainbows and blue, blue skies, better than I realized. Funny how I knew it all along. I beg your pardon, I never promised you a herb garden. I watch the sunshine turn to rain. Yeah, burn rain. I watch the sunshine turn to rain. A little something to ease the pain. Mother stands there dressed in red, sitting by her baby's bed, giving love and attention to the young. Hoping that'll grow up strong, find somewhere where he belongs. Cause wild gardens ain't for everyone. I beg your pardon, I never promised you a herb garden. I watch the sunshine turn to rain. I beg your pardon, I never promised you a herb garden. Just a little something to ease the pain. Sunshine, sunshine. I want the sunshine turn to rain, but sunshine. Some of the sunshine rays. Sunshine. Thank you. Guys, listen, I did a Christmas track like ages ago with EMI. You can check it out on YouTube. It's called Under the Tree with the Water Babies. It's really cool. It's very cracking. It's got snow in it. So check it out. Thank you.
So welcome to the world of the singing show. Let me make you sing and your taste buds. Where all we want for you to see is how we living in a blessed country. Yeah.
Let's see what's happening on the list.
Whoa.
Right. Guyanese. Sunshine. Okay, now we have a special challenge because, of course, our cameraman is a foodie. Okay, so he's gonna come and try, right? Because remember, this food is for everybody under the sun, especially the sons of Guyana. Okay, let's do him a little cup there. So Nigel, please, can you come over here and try this and tell us how it excites you?
Oh, menu.
Hey guys, it's a different type of rice.
Alright.
Okay. Right.
Yep. Shrimp, corn, everything just blend right, you know?
Right,
just,
right, with the balance.
Just balance, yeah, yeah. Really, really good. Yeah. Alright, let me get back to the camera.
Okay guys, if you want to come to, because we do tours, we've got a Singing Chef Adventure Tours. We do like a tour which is Taste of Freedom, which teaches you about, we go to like Victoria and Buxton, you learn about the heritage, basically the heritage of the slaves buying, ex-slaves buying the villages and how Guyana actually really developed. We do the Seven Curry Tour, which is really cool, which explores, you know, Indo-Guyanese, which is really beautiful. You know, with a twist, we always make, you know, we kind of do everything with a twist. And also, we're just going to start the 1 Cent Magenta Tour, which is a tour of the most expensive thing. It's a stamp, but it was made here in Guyana in 1856. And we've got like the whole history. We take you to all the places it was made and all this kind of stuff. But anyway, most of all, what I would like to say is thank you guys for tuning in again to check out the Singing Chef Show. And we'd like to thank all the guys from TBN. You know who they are, you know, Sachin, Nigel, Melody, you know, Akash, Candace. Oh, there's so many of them, right? And like, it's such an incredible crew here, and we just love having people behind us that really support what we're doing and giving us this opportunity. So what I would say is Merry Christmas, you know, and I hope you have an upcoming holiday and all this kind of stuff, but you know, Merry Christmas, and we'll see you. We still have like another show that's coming up, you know, check it out, but this is just a taster, because then we're going full force after Christmas. So see you guys, love you guys, thank you very much from the Singing Chef Show, and this is Guyanese Sunshine Rice.
So welcome to the world of the Singing Chef, that we make you sing and your taste buds. When all we want for you to see is how we're living in a blessed country, yeah.
Well, hey guys, welcome to the Singing Chef Show. And here we are at, we're all getting into this Christmas spirit, and here we are at no better place to do it than at Giffnant Mall. And we've been here before, and we're gonna be interviewing Roy to, you know, gonna tell us about how all this sort of came about. But this is beautiful. This is the place to be in Georgetown.
Eon, why don't you go and sit next to Santa?
Oh, well, no, because Santa is a little bit, I'll tell you what, I'll just touch it on it. Say hello. Hi, Santa. Look, see Santa. Santa's saying hello back.
Okay. All right, so over here, we've got a beautiful display here.
Yeah, look at the Christmas tree on this one.
It's fantastic.
And I love the bears. You know, I just love the way that they're really putting everything into, you know, just make it. You know, it feels like Christmas, you know. It feels like Christmas anywhere.
I just haven't seen so many beautiful decorations. It's really gorgeous, and everyone's flocking here to see them.
Well,
look at it over here.
Huh?
You've got these toy soldiers.
Oh, you got the toy soldiers. You got the snow. You got the gifts. You got the, you know, the beer. It's just, and now we've got like the perfect Christmas tree.
It's beautiful.
Wow, this is, oh my, you see this? This is amazing. I mean, see, this is what Giffnant Mall, a lot of these places are really getting into them. This is so beautiful, you don't miss Christmas anywhere. It's gonna get into it. I mean, look at the reindeers and like all the different colors coming up here. And this food court has never looked so good. This is brilliant, I love it. Look at this. We put all the stuff to make it Christmas. What do we need at Christmas? What do we love at Christmas? Is a chair right next to the chimney. Let me try that. So come to Giffnant Mall. It's Christmas time. Christmas time of the year. Silver. And it wasn't this good. At any time we probably could have caught the fire, but we didn't care. We used to put it up every year.
Okay, so Roy, the last time that we interviewed you, you were young, you were beautiful, and you were sexy, you were well, successful. So much has improved in you since then. So what's your secret?
Yeah, I love change in a year.
You know. It's this inside joke. Okay.
Much. I mean, say, look, the mold catches itself to a large extent. We're 99% full.
Right.
It's been a difficult year. We've had a lot of problems in terms of our power plant.
Right.
But in general, I'd say the mold is taking the type of shape we want it to be.
Uh-huh.
There's a few concessions that have left.
Yeah.
There's been stronger ones that have come in.
Right.
So it makes the overall mold experience much better. When you add to that that Giftland is the largest department store in the Caribbean,
yeah,
and it's getting to a point where it's almost fully stocked, Food Max is undoubtedly the best supermarket in Guyana.
Yeah.
And we have a massive expansion plan from next week.
Right.
Next weekend you'll come and you'll see a brand new Food Max with new produce lines, new fresh produce, imported produce, new frozen food lines. I have two containers about to clear next week. So, you know, the Food Max and the Giftland stores are actually the anchor.
Country.